Good morning, students. Poem 20, Topsy-Turvy Land. Have you ever seen people walk upon their heads? Have you ever seen a front door at the back? So, Topsy-Turvy Land means a place where there is huge confusion, where there is lots of confusion. Have you ever seen that someone or people, they are walking upon their heads instead of their feet? Have you ever seen that the front door is at the back, not in front? So here all the things they are being done in opposite way than what we usually do. Before starting with the poem, let's understand the meanings first. Grand is an adjective, means very good or very enjoyable. Something that is grand means is very good, is very enjoyable. Planned is verb, means made detailed arrangements. When you make arrangements with details, means you have planned. Pleasure is a noun, means a state of being happy. When you are happy, means you have pleasures. Street is noun, means public roads in a city or town. The roads which are there in city or town are streets, but public roads. Topsy-turvy is an adjective, means a state of great confusion. When there is lots of confusion, that is topsy-turvy. Travel is a verb, means to go from one place to another. When you move from one place to another, suppose you go from one city to another, means you are traveling from one city to another. The people walk upon their heads, the sea is made of sand. The children go to school by night in topsy-turvy land. So here the poet has imagined a land where there is lots of confusion and where everything is done in the opposite way. We all walk on our legs, right? So in this topsy-turvy land, people walk upon their hands. The sea is made of sand. In our world, actual world, there is water in sea. But in topsy-turvy land, sea is made of sand. The children, they go to school at night. Actually, children go to school in the morning or in afternoon, but in topsy-turvy land, the children, they go to school at night. The front door step is at the back. You are walking when you stand, you wear your hat upon your foot in topsy-turvy land. The front door step is at the back. When you are walking, you are actually standing. And the hat you wear, you don't wear it on your head, but you wear it upon your feet. So in topsy-turvy land, everything is done in opposite way. And buses on the sea you will meet, while pleasure boats are planned to travel up and down the streets of topsy-turvy land. So buses, they all run on sea. All the buses you see, they are traveling on the sea. And pleasure boats, they are traveling up and down in the streets. So in topsy-turvy land, buses, they travel on water, on sea, not on roads. And boats, they travel on roads instead of water. You pay for what you never get. I think it must be grand. For when you go, you are coming back in topsy-turvy land. When do we pay money? When we are getting something, means when we want to buy something, we pay money. But here in topsy-turvy land, we pay when we never get anything for that. I think it must be grand, means I think it must be very enjoyable, it must be fun. Because when we are going, we are actually coming back. This poem is written by H.E. Wilkinson. Here the poet wants you to think differently. So he has given the idea that whatever we do normally can be done in different ways also. Answer the following questions. Question 1. What is the meaning of topsy-turvy? Answer. Topsy-turvy is a state or condition in which everything is just the opposite of all the normal things we see or do. Whatever normal things we see or we do then, it's just the opposite of all those normal things. That state or that condition is topsy-turvy. Question 2. What do you think the shore is made of if the sea is made of sand? We know that when we go to seashore, The sand is on the shore and the water is in the sea, but here in topsy-turvy land, sea is made up of sand. So what do you think? What is there on the shore? Answer: if the sea is made of sand, then the shore is made of salty water, as it is a topsy-turvy land. So in topsy-turvy land, everything is just opposite of what normally it should be. So here, if the sea is made of sand, then the shore must be made up of salty water. Question 3. Find two pairs of rhyming words from the poem. We have to find the rhyming words, means the words which have similar sounds. Sand, its rhyming word is land. Meat, its rhyming word is feet. Question 4. What do you find the most exciting in topsy-turvy land and why? What do you like the most in topsy-turvy land and what is the reason? Answer: I like most of the things in the topsy-turvy land because sometimes when things work in an unexpected way, it brings fun and excitement in our life. For a change, it would be fun to have bus rides in the sea and boat trips on the road. So answer is that I like mostly everything in the topsy-turvy land because it's already opposite of what we do normally and this makes it fun and we can have lots of excitement. So here an example is given that if someday we ride the buses in the sea and if we take boat trips on the road, then that would be great fun. Question 5. In the poem you will find, what do you find in the poem? Buses on the sea. Buses are on the sea. Question 6. Find the opposites of these words from the poem. So words are given, we have to find their opposites from the poem. First word is day, opposite is night. Displeasure, opposite is pleasure. See, sit, its opposite is stand. Question 7. Which line in the poem suggests that all this is good? There is one line given in the poem that suggests that everything is good in the topsy-turvy land. That line is, I think it must be grand. Question 8. Make a list of things with your friends that you could do if you visited topsy-turvy land. If by chance you visit topsy-turvy land, what are the things that you would like to do with your friends? Answer: if my friends and I lived in topsy-turvy land, we would like to do several things. For example, A. Eat lots of ice cream in winter because generally we eat ice cream in summer, but in topsy-turvy land, I would like to eat ice cream in winter. B. Watch snowfall during summer. Snowfall occurs during winter, but in topsy-turvy land, I would like to watch snowfall during summer. Over here, poem 20 is complete. I hope you have understood the meanings, poem and question answers I explained. Thank you.